everyone, it's Margaret Manning here. Welcome to 60 and Me. This is the place where women over 60 come to be inspired. My guest today is Jess Jannenga. Jessica is a fashion blogger. She has a wonderful site. It's called elegantlydressedandstylish.com. And that kind of says really all it is about her style. It's elegant and classic style, but it's much more than that. And we're going to talk a lot about that today. So welcome, Jessica.
Thank you. I'm very glad to be here, Margaret.
I'm really thrilled to have you here. You know, we have a big community of women over 60 and really over 50. They're kind of a big spectrum. And they, often define themselves in terms of what their fashion sense is. And very often that those words romantic, feminine, stylish come up. So right. Tell me a bit about your sort of sense of style first. Personally,
I just have always had kind of more of a feminine flair with the way I dress. Mm-hmm. I like to be comfortable, but yet I feel like comfort and style can go hand in hand. Yeah. So I do wear a lot of florals. People kind of know me as a floral girl, but I like the larger, bolder prints in those styles. I love lace, well-made lace. Mm-hmm. I do love silk and just any kind of like flowy dress that I can think of. These are really styles that show my personality.
Well, you have got the most gorgeous hair. How long is your hair, Jessica? How far does it go down your back? Down the halfway?
It's just about there.
Oh my gosh. It is beautiful. Well, I think, your site is one of those sites that really appeals to people along a spectrum of, everything from it's a fashion blog, but it's also a lifestyle blog. And you talk about how fashion has been woven into your life. And I want to ask you some questions about that later. But in terms of what you can do, like ideas for people who love feminine fashion, what are some things that you would suggest that they try?
Well, I do think that sometimes we get caught up with like large statement pieces with necklaces, and there's certainly nothing wrong with that. I love those pieces myself, but I sometimes think that the delicate vintage inspired earring or brooch would be a great piece to add to the wardrobe. Mm-hmm. I love block heels. I think that was the greatest invention as far as shoes go.
Yeah.
Because you can actually walk in them and you're comfortable.
Yeah.
But they're still stylish. There's still a feminine look to them, and they're all over the place right now.
Mm-hmm.
So there are a few things.
So talk about colors, for example. What kind of colors would you choose if you were, helping someone choose a feminine style?
I love color. I used to wear all black, and I can go into that later on, but I feel like I'm just expressing myself more, and I love how it will go with your skin tone as far as like really showing who you are. So some of the colors I've worn are more, soft colors,
right.
Pastels look beautiful. You can really wear blush as a color. It's actually one of the trending colors right now. And wear it with some colors that may be unexpected, like olive or burgundy. It's a color that is popular year round, but yet it continues to pop up in the fall as being one of the trendy colors.
So when you say blush, do you mean like a peach color or a pink color?
It's a light, very light pale pink.
Okay. One of my favorites. I love pink.
Yeah, I do. Yeah. And it really goes well with all skin tones. So it's great shade to have in your wardrobe.
I think that's a nice comment, though. To make too is that when you're looking at pastel colors, don't be afraid to do a little spot of dark color, like they said, olive green.
Right. One of the sources that I use for seeing what colors are going to be coming up in the next season is the Pantone Color Institute.
Yes,
they are fabulous. If you don't know about it, it's a color institute that they issue shades of color for New York, and this year also London. They're showing at color palettes of about 10 to 12 different colors, and I feel like you should experiment with color. Don't get stuck in a rut of wearing the same color all the time. Maybe try orange, and orange is very popular again this year.
Mm-hmm.
So orange, and mix that with navy, mix it with olive. There's take the color palette and kind of experiment, because that's what will be showing up in stores too.
I think what you're saying here is really interesting, though, too, that feminine, normally you think of very kind of subdued colors, but what you're saying is
Right.
soft is good and probably on the more feminine side, but play with the edges, play with the extremes and have fun.
Right.
What about
Right.
necklines? I mean, what kind of necklines and would you say, you think of the traditional feminine with the high neckline. What would you
Right.
say?
Well, I do like the pussy bow blouses. I think those are very feminine. Lots of ways to style those. Bring in a wear a menswear vest, for instance. Maybe a little mix of feminine and masculine in there.
That's cool.
Style it with a pretty lace skirt. There's lots of ways that you could wear that type of blouse. Wear it with a pair of boyfriend jeans. Again, it's kind of like mixing up the unexpected a little bit, but still keeping the feminine side. By doing that, if you wore a pussy bow blouse and boyfriend jeans, maybe you make your, I have a pair of pearl, darn, I didn't bring them down with me. I have a pair of pearl sandals. The block heel has pearls in them. So you're still keeping that feminine side, but adding a little bit of fun with the boyfriend jeans.
That's a really fresh, modern way of looking at feminine, I think. And so, for example, what about like dresses? I mean, I know you're a big dress person. When I looked at your website, I saw tons of beautiful pictures. How would a person who likes feminine style wear her dresses?
Well, I love dresses. I am. It's like one of those things where you're trying, if you're thinking about defining your style, I was thinking about that just the other day, and I have to be defined as a person that loves dresses, loves skirts. I just find them, I feel better wearing a dress, and it's actually relatively ease of styling. You're thinking about accessories and things like that beyond the dress and mixing colors. I feel like the kind of dresses I love, I do wear bodycon dresses. I think those can look smashing as long as you keep your modesty and perhaps you wear it down to your knee, not show so much up top, but it can be worn, wear it with, just make sure the fit is right. And bodycon dress is a lovely dress. I
By
also,
bodycon, by the way, it's just in case, because I didn't know what a bodycon dress was.
oh,
And no,
sure.
seriously, it's a tight dress. It's a dress made out of kind of a stretchy, tight lycra. It's not
Right.
slinky lycra.
I have several of them in like neoprene fabric.
Very, very
And
tight, very
so
stiff,
they are very comfortable. But if you yourself feel like, oh, I'd be more comfortable, undergarments are a good thing to consider with the bodycon dress, just in case you want a smooth silhouette. So that's always something to think about. I also love long flowy dresses. I think flowy is feminine. Like larger florals, and what's very big for fall is the dark floral. That's coming around again. Very popular last year, but it's another thing that's popular this year.
It changes from season to season, of course, and also country to country. But I've actually noticed here a lot of burgundy. This is in Switzerland, a lot of burgundy. And like you were saying, dark florals, like a lot of burgundy
Right.
florals, like on a cream or, but the big flowers, like not
Right.
little petite ones, but big flowers.
I think that's another way of having it be more of a modern print. If you have sometimes the tiny little flowers and buds that kind of look, I don't want to say grandma-ish, but
Yeah,
it's kind
exactly.
of looks a little bit older and dated. So having a fresher, bolder, dark print is another way to look feminine but
Yeah.
still modern.
I'm really glad that the conversation's gone this way, actually, because I think that when you start thinking, of a title, feminine fashion for women, you start thinking immediately of stereotypes around what feminine means. I mean, you talked
Right.
about soft colors, high necklines, like the use of lace, long dresses, floral. I mean, these things are all being modernized. Okay,
Right.
I was in Tara the other Zara, not Tara, Zara the
That's my
other day.
store.
You like that store?
Loves
We have a nice one here, and so I went in, and I was really smiling because there's lots of lace,
it.
and also bling, like a beret with a stone on it.
Right.
They just did, they're starting to add little feminine touches. Have you
Touches.
noticed
Yeah.
that?
That is wonderful. Yeah, I actually was looking on their site the other day, and what I really loved was it was a bow, in emerald, and it had a jewel in the middle.
Oh,
And it was
wow.
just worn as like a choker. And I thought, is that wonderful? And you could also add it to just like a button-down shirt. Let's say you have just a, I have, everybody owns a white button-down shirt. So if you have one of those and you want to really bling it up and make it more exciting.
I've got this brooch here, see, and I actually put them on my pearls, you know, like
That's
just,
fabulous.
You know, just mix and match. And I think that the feminine things that we, you know, like vintage, like you were saying, they can be now added to modern looks, asymmetrical or whatever,
well,
you know, so it's very cool.
I have an idea. I'll show you.
Show me.
I brought it. I actually put it on.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
So this is a jean jacket and just one that I had bought. I think it was Forever 21 I picked up. And I collect vintage brooches. So what I did
so
was
cool.
just take pearl, some of the pearl ones and make a cluster out of them. And
that
so,
looks really sweet. I like, and what would you wear with that? Would you wear like a floral skirt or something or dress?
I probably would. I'd probably style it with maybe a straight dress, a floral dress, or really you could wear just about anything with that. Jean jackets are
cool.
so versatile.
Do you know, I don't own a jean jacket. I maybe need to go buy one because you're inspiring me to make them. I mean, that just changed the whole jacket by adding those three, not just one, but three themed brooches.
Right.
Yeah.
I feel like the brooches are great because you can add them to a hat.
Yes.
If you have,
sure.
you know, the side, you have the ribbon, you can add it to a hat. And like I mentioned with the Zara piece, if you have, let's say you have a tie, like a more feminine kind of tie. And you want to put on the brooch in the center. So that'll add to the focal detail and people will think that's very interesting, you know.
I love the word interesting. I think that's, for me, that's how fashion should be. It should be conversation starter and it should speak for you.
Right. I always feel like it, to me, it's always a creative expression.
Mm.
I feel like if you're just going into your closet, humdrum, picking up something that you're not truly excited about, that's not fun. You want to have it be an expression of yourself.
Well, you are certainly an expression of femininity and romantic fashion. And I'm really glad we talked about those five ideas. I think women are going to love them. And I'd love to get some more pictures from you of your brooch collection. It sounds like you've got some wonderful...
I did bring some down.
Oh, did you? Well, we'll talk about that in another video, but that will be really great. But thank you so much for this one. This has been great on romantic style. Thanks so much, Jessica.
You're welcome.
Take care. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our 60 and Me YouTube channel and also visit our website. We are a strong and dynamic community of women over 60. We're challenging aging stereotypes, and every day we share fascinating stories, interesting questions, and great conversation.